Let's then start by creating our project. All we need for this system is a 3D project. Unless there's any current problem with using HDRP or UARP with CineMachine or the new input system, we should be able to choose any 3D template we want. I'll go with a simple normal 3D template. For the Unity version I'm currently using 2020.3, but you should be able to use any you want. I do recommend at least 2020 as you'll be using serialized properties, but if you are using 2019, that should be fine as well. Simply swap the properties with public variables instead, or use non-automatic properties. For the name and folder of the project, choose the one you desire. We'll start by setting up a base namespace to make sure no name conflicts happen. To do that, we go to Edit, Project Settings, Editor, and scroll down to Root Namespace. I'll name mine Genshin Impact Movement System. Of course, give it a name you like. For simplicity, this will be the only namespace we'll be adding in this tutorial. I also went ahead to Kenny's website and downloaded his prototype textures. You can use normal materials if you prefer, in case you don't feel like downloading them. I'll have mine be inside of a folder named Materials. Next, let's download CineMachine. To do that, we go to Window, Package Manager, and choose Packages from Unity Registry, and search for CineMachine. Make sure you select the latest version here, which by the time of this video is 2.8.4. This is simply because there are some bugs happening in the older versions, so we are just making sure we've got a working one. If by the time you watch this video the default version is at least 2.8.4, then you should be fine. When that's done, press Install. When CineMachine is done installing and importing, go ahead and search for Input System. Select it and feel free to install it with the default version. A warning should show up asking you if you want to disable the old input system. While it's not necessary, we don't need the old input system for this tutorial, so I'll go ahead and press Yes. To note that this will restart your project. If you chose No, make sure that in Edit, Project Settings, Player, and Other Settings, your active input handling is set to both or input system package new. Your project will also restart when you change this option. That's all for our packages, so we'll now go ahead and start downloading our character model and its animations. We'll of course be using a free model and free animations, so do not expect them to look as good as Genshin Impact animations. To do that, we'll be using a website owned by a dev named Mixamo. So go ahead and open up mixamo.com. You'll need to log in with an Adobe account to download the assets, but you can create an account using Google or Facebook if you do have them. When you are logged in, go ahead and open the Characters tab. This is a list of character models we can choose from. You can choose any character you want, but I'll go ahead and search for YBot and select it. Once you have your character model selected, press Download at the top right. For the format, make sure you choose FBX for Unity. I'll leave the pose as T-Pose. When that's done, press Download again. I'll be renaming the file to Character Model. Then, in Unity, I'll create a new folder named Models, followed by Characters, and player inside. And then drag our character model here. With our character model in Unity, we of course need its animations. So back into Mixamo, go on to the Animations tab. We now have a list of animations we can download. For now, we'll only be downloading animations for our base movement system. Note that the only important setting in the Download tab is a format option, which shall be set to FBX in Unity. I'll also be renaming the files, but I'll leave the new names in the screen. Here is a list of animations I'll be downloading. Idle. Walking. With an overdrive of 15 and the in-place option enabled. Running around the bottom, with the in-place option enabled, running above a bit, with the in-place option enabled, idle to sprint, run to stop, at the right, stop walking, with a starting trim of around 45, stop walking again, but with an overdrive of 25, character arm space of 55, and starting trim of 50. Jumping on the second tab at the right. With a starting trim of around 37. And falling to landing. With a starting trim of around 22. We have all of the animations we need, so it's time to add their files into Unity. Before we do that, make sure you have the following names in your animation files. Back into Unity, select all of our animation files and drag them into our models folder. Now, these are models that come with an animation. We already have our base model, so we of course only want the animation clips, so we'll have to extract them out of the assets we have just imported. If we go ahead and open up one of the assets by clicking on the arrow icon, we can see a bunch of other assets inside. The one we want is the last asset, which is an animation clip. Now, if you kept the YBot at part of the file name, your animation clip should have the same name as the text that follows it. This is why I've asked you to rename the files. If you did rename the files to not contain the YBot at part or whatever name your character model has, then the animation clip will come named as mixamo.com and you'll have to rename them through Unity instead. So I recommend just renaming and redragging the assets with the correct names. To get these animations out of our assets, we simply open up every asset, Ctrl-click each of the animation clips. And then press Ctrl-D to duplicate them. When that's done, we won't be needing the downloaded assets anymore, so feel free to remove them. Do not remove the character model asset though. We now have our animations, so let's add them to a new folder. In the Assets folder, create a new folder named Animations, followed by Characters, Player, Clips, and States. I'll drag every single animation to the States folder. Then, inside of this States folder, I'll create a few more folders. Moving, Stopping, Landing, Grounded, and Airborne. I'll add the walk, run, and sprint animations to the moving folder. Then I'll add the light, medium, and hard stop animations to the stopping folder. The light landing animation will go to the landing folder. When that's done, drag the jump animation to the airborne folder. Whatever remains here except the airborne folder will be moved onto the grounded folder. It's alright if you have no idea what these folder names mean, as it will become clear later on. We are just adding them now for organization purposes and do not need to do it later. Before we keep going, there were some animations that we have downloaded that didn't really have the in-place option. This means that they will move the player forward without our input, which is something we do not want. We will change that in the following animations. Start by right-clicking in the Project tab and add a new animation tab. I'll dock it to the right for a bit and resize it. Then double-click on the dash animation on the grounded folder. The animation window shall now have all the keyframes of this specific animation. Open up the Ips Position tab and select All X on Z keyframes. Then press the Delete key to delete them. Repeat these steps for the light stop, medium stop, and hard stop animations in the stopping folder as well. Next, we'll need to change some of the animations to keep looping after they run once. We can do that by enabling the loop time option in the animation clip. We'll do it for the idle animation and the walk, run, and sprint animations. Our animations are now set up properly.